Hopefully I didn't unplug something that's going to electrocute me. Okay. Everything seems to be opening, or starting up all right. Got the green light. The internet's running in there. No sparks. Green light's not blinking. So let me fire this up. No allergic reaction so far. Come up to the monitor. And it says no device detected. Insert system disk and press F1 to continue, or press F2 for setup. Just out of kicks and whistles, I'm gonna go ahead and go to F2 and see what it does. Alright, the peripheral configurations are still disabled. Let me back out of that. Okay, quick boot is both enabled. It's at hard drive, CD-ROM, floppy, and disabled. That's what I programmed into it. I'm gonna resituate it to CD-ROM, then hard drive, then floppy. And what the heck? I'll go from there, and I'm gonna go ahead and save those that, and we'll see what happens. No boot device detected. Insert system disk and press F1 to continue, or press F2 for setup menu. So, I'm not going to be able to do anything much with this. I'm going to go ahead and give up on it and consider this just a piece of junk. The whole issue that I've had with every older computer that I've dealt with is the fact that, you know, they're You have to have parts that are compatible, and whenever you get a device that is so old that the parts aren't compatible and you don't have those parts, then it becomes hard to find somebody who does have those parts. So this is my biggest issue with all of them. I've already had 3 Dells that I just can't fix because I can't find any reliable places that have the parts. So, alright, I pulled all of the cords, the cords and everything out for the hard drive, and you see if I can get a shot without my shadow being in it. Wanted to take a shot of this because it's pretty interesting. I over the fan, the setup they've got right there, that's really something. This right here, it's kind of dark like that. Give you some light. That's what it looks like. Right here, there's a pulley like this, and a pulley like this, and then to get this open, I had to push down on this, so I'm wondering what that pulley was for. Maybe, down underneath is what it was, but I just wanted to show that. get some shots of it. That is the setup there. Shadowy. But the issues I had was these connectors right here, and this connector right here, but then this right here doesn't even have I can't even get a good shot of that where you can see it, but it doesn't have a good thing to where it goes into the motherboard down here at all. Okay, so since everything that was in here was pretty much outdated and hard to figure out, I went ahead and I started taking everything out and I replaced it with new stuff. Just going to do a new build from it. The motherboard for this that I have set up in here seems to match up with the back facing pretty well. The screws even go into the same spots. I'm going to have to figure out the wiring and everything that goes to it when it comes to the front paneling. But I pretty much replaced everything in here. I went ahead and left the top DVD driver up on top right there. I left that. That is all I have. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, please like, subscribe, share. Thanks for watching. This is Roger Hansen. Bye.